Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist with Camping World, and today we're going to go over the 2018 Cougar 32 RLI. This is a beautiful couples coach, nice big rear living here. You see the huge dual opposing slides that give you a massive living space and nice large kitchen with the center island. If you take a quick look at the ceiling here, you'll see you have a barreled ceiling as well. So that way it doesn't feel closed in or claustrophobic, feels nice and open and airy and spacious, just exactly what you want in your RV. You'll also see there's not one, but two rows of LED lights here to make sure everything is nice and bright. And you have LED lights in your slide outs and basically every nook and cranny, really brightening this space up. You also see going across here, you have your wood strips just to give it a little bit different look than your standard white tape. And then right there is your ducted AC with a quick dump option. If we take a look over here at our campsite super slide, you'll see you have freestanding table and chairs, which again is what you'd expect in a luxury travel trailer. The chairs do have storage underneath here. And the table isn't mounted, it just came from the manufacturer, needs to be bolted down. But the cool thing about this is it does have a nice pop-up leaf here, so you get a little bit of extra space in case you do have four people eating a meal. Windows all the way around, I mean, take a look. These are large windows, folks. A lot of times manufacturers will have windows here, but they're much smaller. This entire wall right here is basically window. That lets in a ton of natural light. You also have windows on both sides of the slide here. And at night, you have LED lights going across the entire top of the slide. If you take a look right here, you have dual theater seating. And I'm telling you, this is probably one of the hottest layouts right now when it comes to rear living campers. And that is you have your theater seating with your TV directly across, because that's what you want. You want to be able to just put your feet up, sit back, relax, and watch TV. You also have some cup holders here in case you have a beverage or two, and you have this nice little center console where you can stash your remotes. If we take a quick look at the back, you have a nice tri-fold sofa, quite comfortable. Of course, armrest built in as you would expect. You know, some of the jackknife sofas don't have armrests and it can kind of be awkward to sit on. Not the case at all here, extremely comfortable, Thomas Paine collection. The trifold sofa is not only comfortable to sit on, but also very comfortable to sleep on. If you've never seen a trifold, you can see the cushion right here that you get. That's essentially what you get to sleep on. You just pull this bottom part up and out, that back part folds down, you remove these cushions here, and that creates a bed that's quick and easy to set up, as well as comfortable for your guests. And on both sides, you have end tables, large end tables even. And underneath those, you see you have some cubby holes, so a little bit extra storage. You also have electrical outlets on both sides in case you need to plug anything in. Some windows here, again, for that natural light. And just like on our slide, you have a huge window in the back, large rear picture window. So if you're at a campsite where you have a beautiful view out the back, maybe a lake, pond, ocean, you can certainly enjoy it here. Again, LED lights and storage all the way across the top. You can see kind of the nice designer glass they have on there. It gives it a pretty nice look too. If we go across the other side, this is our entertainment center. So we have our 50-inch TV. So big TV here, folks. You know, if you can't see it from the theater seating, you should probably get some glasses, get your eyes checked. You should certainly be able to see this one. You'll also see you have a multimedia center right here. This is a radio, CD, and DVD player. So if you want to watch a movie, pop it in right there. You can watch it on the 50-inch here and enjoy movies while you're camping. If you need a place to store those movies, there you go. You have that on both sides. LED light here too. I'd probably have it off when watching TV. That way you don't get the glare, but you know, it does have a nice look to it if you're having guests over. Underneath, you have the fireplace there. So the cool thing about a fireplace is not only do they look really neat, but also they make great space heaters. So if you're at a park and you don't want to run your propane, you know, you have shore power, turn this on. It'll do a good job of taking the chill off in this space. As we move forward a little bit further, we get into the kitchen. So as I had previously mentioned, one of the big advantages of having dual opposing slides is that you get a beautiful center island. And this is the ideal prep space. This is what you want to have to be able to cook and prepare meals. So you have space on both sides of the sink. This is a thermoformed countertop on here, which allows them to undermount the double stainless steel bowl. Granted, there's some antifreeze in there, but large, deep bowls, very modern cut, and you have the high-rise modern pull-out faucet here, too. If we take a look in front, you'll see there is dual electrical outlets. So if you need to plug in, you know, a blender, if you want to make some margaritas or maybe a toaster, whatever else you need to plug in, you have the electrical outlets there to do it. You take a quick look underneath here. You see you have some divided storage here, and then they left this one open, which again, I like when manufacturers do that too, because that gives you a place in which you can put a trash can. Right over here is the Dometic fridge freezer combo. Open this guy up for you. They kind of have a suite of black appliances throughout this camper. You can see there you have plenty of space cut out here for some of your taller items. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. Next to that is your microwave here with a hood underneath, fully functional with a light and a fan as you'd expect. Some storage right here next to that. Window below, so you're able to, again, get some natural light in here. Electrical outlet off to the side. Now, if you want, you can put a coffee maker here. Myself, I'd probably put it over on what I call the coffee bar, but at least you do have that electrical outlet for whatever else you want to plug in. Maybe put an electric griddle here, right? Do some extra cooking. Speaking of cooking, 3-burner cooktop recessed with a glass cover. That way you can utilize this as prep space as well. Fold this up and back, kind of doubles as a backsplash there. You see the 3 burners. Front one is high output, and underneath that you have a large oven. If we take a look underneath the oven here, you'll see you have a drawer there, as well as a bank of 4 full extension drawers right over here. Take a look at that. I love when manufacturers put in a lot of drawer space like this. It gives you a space for your silverware, your larger utensils like your spoons, spatulas, place for your hot pads, everything else you need, tongs, you can put them right in there. So as I previously mentioned, this is what I would call my coffee bar. At least that's what I would do with it. You do have an electrical outlet right up here tucked away, so you can put your coffee maker right here in the corner, you know, put all your specialty coffees or whatever else you want, you know, maybe a French press or something there. Take a look underneath though, huge storage there too. I would probably store pots and pans in here, but whatever you want to do, you know, when you own it, it's up to you. And then next to that, again, some good additional storage right there. If we take a look up top, you also have storage all the way across here. And then tucked away on the side here is your control panel. What they did do is they did frame it out in wood to make it look a little bit nicer there, and also they're able to hide some electronics behind you and give you more storage space. But basically everything you need is centrally located right there. And it is up high enough, you don't have to worry about kids or grandkids coming in here and playing with your slides or awnings or anything like that. The bathroom in the 32 RLI is nice and spacious. You see you have plenty of room to move around in here. Foot flush lever, porcelain bowl, so easy to clean. And again, plenty of leg room. I'm pretty wide up top in the shoulders and I have plenty of shoulder width in here too. If you look directly up above, you'll see you have several robe hooks here, so you have a place to hang a couple different towels. Right up above that is your vent fan to quickly help moisture escape. If we take a look across the way, LED light here above your vanity, so you can see yourself in the mirrored medicine cabinet with storage behind that, of course. Underneath that, nice big sink here. It is quite large. Some countertop space on the sides, electrical outlet, of course. And underneath, you have nice open storage. I like this too because that actually has enough room where you can put a trash can in the bathroom as well. And then right over here in the corners, your neo-angle shower. Take a step in here just to give you an idea of shower height. So, you know, because it's a barreled ceiling at the narrowest point will be right here. I'm 6 foot and I still have a couple inches. If I move forward, especially with this skylight, you know, you have plenty of room in here, which is nice. You also have the roller doors and a track. So that way when you're done showering, you open the doors up. All the water that you just used, it's on the inside of the doors, goes down into the shower pan rather than all over your floor. And then as you'd expect, you have a hand wand there to make it easy to shower and some shelves right behind me too. Over to the side, I love when manufacturers can do this too, and that is give you a large linen closet. This gives you plenty of room for all of your towels and all your other bathroom goodies, whether it be, you know, toilet paper or health and beauty products. You have plenty of space to store those. The bedroom has a big slide out opening up this space right around the bed here. So you can see you have plenty of room to be able to get dressed in the morning. For privacy, if you have additional guests sleeping on your trifold sofa, it also has a nice slider door here rather than a curtain as you would expect. In that slide, as I mentioned, is the bed. This is a Camper King. It is 70 inches wide by 74 inches long. Windows on both sides of the slide. You have the leather headboard there. You have an LED reading light and then some additional storage across the top of the slide. Right here in the nose is your wardrobe. So very similar to what you get in a fifth wheel. You see you have the hanging rod going all the way across there. Some additional storage up top, LED light there. You have mirrored doors on here too, and an electrical outlet down by the side of the bed in case you need to plug in cell phones or like a CPAP machine. Right here at the foot of the bed, you have a ton of storage too. Starting up top, we'll open this up. You can see all that storage all the way across there. Four doors, window right here, and then underneath, take a look at how deep these drawers are. These are some huge drawers here, folks, which are awesome. So if you have, you know, a lot of folded clothes, you can fit a lot in there. You get four of those. And then right off to the side here, this is pretty neat too. You know, I personally like having a trash can close to my bedroom or in my bedroom at home. So right there, you know, it's nice and easy to toss things, throw them away. Then if you do want a TV, they put a backer right here in the wall for you. You can see those appropriate connections for that TV as well. And lastly, if you take a quick look at the ceiling, you have a vent here for cross ventilation, but more importantly, this is ducted for a second AC. So if you expect to spend a lot of time in warmer regions, might not be a bad idea to have that installed to make sure you stay nice and cool. Now that we've seen the inside, let's take a quick look at some of the outside features on the Cougar 32 RLI. Starting right up front here, as you'd expect on a premium travel trailer, you have a powered tongue jack. This makes it nice and easy to raise and lower the tongue. You also have a light right up front here for some extra visibility at night. Directly behind that, you have two 30-pound propane tanks, so larger than your standard 20s there. With the cover here, very easy to access those tanks. Just undo these two thumb screws, lift up the door, and you are down and in. Right behind that, you will see you have rails there for your battery, and if you need to have two batteries installed, there's enough room for that as well. If we take a look at the front end here, you'll see the bottom half, rather than the diamond plating, they have this nice rock guard on here because you have this beautiful front cap here. The thing I love about a front cap, one, it just gives a really nice look to the front of any RV. Just really makes your travel trailer stand out. Plus, it also adds some extra insulation value in there. Nice and easy to clean as well. And take a look at this, folks. This is really cool too. This has a 3-year warranty on there. That's a big deal. 3-year structural warranty, so you know that they are certainly standing behind their product. When you come around to the side, you have the pass-through. See how you have a covered hinge here? That way you don't have a bunch of rust coming down your door. This is magnetic, so you can just put it up there and not have to worry about it. And if we take a look inside the pass-through, you can see it's pretty good size here. You'll notice you have a light right over to the side right here. There is some other stuff on the off-door side, but we'll get to that a little bit later. Take a look at the side. Not only do you have one power awning, but you actually have two. You have another awning right here on the slide itself. So basically, this entire side of the camper is all awning covered, which is awesome. Just touch a button to roll that out. Same thing to have it go back in. And you have LED light strips there, so you have light at night. You'll see you have two outside speakers there. Those are controlled by that multimedia center inside. However, that unit is Bluetooth capable. So that way you can sit out here with your phone or tablet and be able to connect to that and listen to the music via Bluetooth. If you'd like outside TV, right here's your TV hookups. Nice and simple to get to. And again, this is directly underneath your awning. You have three aluminum steps to get into the Cougar here with the foldable easy grab handle to ensure that you have excellent control. The aluminum steps also have the grip tape on there, so that way if it is, you know, raining like it just did, or if it's early in the morning, it's wet out, you have some grip so you don't slip and fall. The great thing about aluminum steps though is that they won't rust on you, so they will continue to look nice year after year. This one is equipped with the polar package as well in case you're camping, you know, in the late fall, early spring, and it has an enclosed underbelly as well, which again helps with some of the insulation, and it also helps keep some of the critters out of there as well as the road grime during travel. If you take a look right underneath here, you'll see the aluminum alloy wheels. Great thing about those is not only do they look nice, but because they're aluminum, they will continue to do so. Behind that, you see your part of your ground control 3.0. We'll get to this a little bit later, but folks, this travel trailer has full auto level. Not just power stabilizer jacks, but actual auto level, which is awesome. And behind that, you have your BAL tire carrier. You can see that right there where your spare tire is. Now, it certainly isn't as easy to get to as it would be if we're mounted on the rear. However, it frees up all that room on the back, and that tire carrier allows you to pull it out, so that way you don't have to actually climb under the RV to be able to get at it. So let's take a quick look at the back. Starting right here, you see you have your rear cargo rack. I love when manufacturers put this on for a couple different reasons. One is utility. You know, you can use it exactly what it's for, a cargo rack. Drop it down, put bikes, totes, coolers, wood, whatever you want to on there, 225-pound capacity. But the other thing I like about it is the fact that because it comes from the manufacturer, that means this obviously won't void your warranty. A lot of times if you strap something onto your bumper, it voids your entire warranty for your RV. Not the case here. You'll also see you have a rear-mounted ladder, so you can quickly and easily climb up onto the roof, large rear picture window, and then you also have backup camera prep. This is a pretty good sized travel trailer. Having that prep makes it a lot less expensive to have a backup camera installed. So we take a look at the off-door side here. Right in the back is your convenience center, which is exactly where you want it. Nice little docking station here. You see you have your outside shower with both hot and cold water access, black tank flush, both your satellite and cable inlets here. And then over to this side, you have your water fill. You have the lever here to decide if you want to do city fill or fill up your tanks. Right next to that is your 50 amp detachable power cord plug-in. As we move forward a tiny bit here, move right up beyond this slide. See right down here are terminations. You do have one valve tucked away right here. The other one is actually tucked up here a little bit further. You do have to get down in there to be able to grab that one, but just so you know, that's where it's hiding at. Then take a look at this. You do have solar prep here as well. So if you want solar, all you have to do is buy the portable panels, plug them in right there, and it will trickle charge your battery. If the pass-through storage there wasn't quite enough for you, you do have all this extra storage right here, which is awesome. So large extra storage area, plus the pass-through, and you had that big cargo tray on the back. Speaking of the pass-through, let's come up here and take one more quick look. In the very beginning, I promised you there was some other stuff out here, and so I want to show you. So one is you have a battery disconnect right here. This is great, makes it nice and easy to kill all power to the RV. You know, you don't have to worry about getting in your battery box, just flip the switch and that's it. Right above that is your auto level system. So the great thing about this is it's literally one touch of a button, folks. The instructions for it are right here in case you ever do forget. But you know, it uses the tongue jack as well as your four leveling jacks. Touch a button, walk away, does the rest for you. And it has a memory, so when you're done camping, it'll actually go right to where you dropped it off at, so you can back in your tow vehicle, hook up, and head home. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is the 2018 Keystone Cougar 32 RLI. If you're interested in this RV and you'd like price and availability, simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.